This video contains a 10-minute guided meditation written by me, Dr. Andrew Doan, and then followed by 50 minutes of relaxing scenery, music, sounds, and biblical quotes to help calm and reduce your anxiety.
Hello, my name is Amanda, and I will guide you through the body scan meditation. Find a comfortable seated or lying down position. Close your eyes gently. Begin by taking a few deep breaths, inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. Use your diaphragm to breathe deeply, moving air in through the nose and exhaling through your mouth. Allow yourself to settle into this moment. Bring your attention to your feet. Notice the sensation of your feet touching the floor or bed. Feel the weight, temperature, and any tingling or numbness. Repeat for each digit of your feet, releasing any tension with each exhale. Move your awareness up to your legs, your calves, knees, and thighs. Notice any sensations, tightness, or discomfort. Continue to breathe slowly and deeply, allowing them to relax and soften. Shift your attention to your hips and pelvis. Observe any tension or weight there. With each breath, imagine these areas becoming more relaxed and grounded. Bring your focus to your torso. feel your abdomen rise and fall with your breath. Notice your chest, your back, and your ribs. Breathe slowly and deeply, letting go with each exhale. Shift your awareness to your hands and arms. Feel the weight of your arms and the sensations in your fingers. If there's any tension, imagine it flowing out through your fingertips. Do this for all of your fingers while breathing slowly and deeply. Move your focus up to your shoulders and neck. Many of us hold tension here. Breathe deeply into these areas, allowing the shoulders to drop away from the ears and the neck to lengthen. Bring your attention to your face. Soften the muscles around your eyes, your mouth, and your forehead. Feel the weight of your head and let it be supported. Breathe slowly and deeply, letting go with each exhale. Now, expand your awareness to encompass your entire body. Feel the gentle rhythm of your breath as it flows through you. Picture your body as a whole, from the tips of your toes to the top of your head, fully present in this moment. begin to deepen your breath, bringing some gentle movement back into your fingers and toes. Slowly, when you're ready, open your eyes. Take a moment to acknowledge the gift you've given yourself by being present with your body. If you must go, thank you for visiting, and I hope you have a wonderful day. For those who can stay, there's 50 minutes of relaxing videos, sounds, and quotes I will read to you to help you deal with anxiety. Quotes and verses will be spoken about every minute. Take a moment to embrace the wisdom and beauty of the quotes and verses as they resonate with your soul, inviting reflection. While listening, take deep, slow breaths, allowing the tension to be released. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. Philippians 4 verse 6. When the cares of my heart are many, your consolations cheer my soul. Psalm 94, verse 19. Cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you. 1 Peter 5, verse 7. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41 verse 10. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. Matthew 6, verse 34. Therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Matthew 6, verse 25. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Psalm 23, verse 1. Cast your burden on the Lord, and He will sustain you. He will never permit the righteous to be moved. Psalm 55, verse 22. I can do all things through Him who strengthens me. Philippians 4, verse 13. Thank you. For I, the Lord your God, hold your right hand. It is I who say to you, fear not, I am the one who helps you. Isaiah 41 verse 13. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Matthew 11 verse 28. And which of you, by being anxious, can add a single hour to his span of life? Matthew 6 verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. John 14 verse 27. Be strong, and let your heart take courage, all you who wait for the Lord. Psalm 31 verse 24. When anxiety was great within me, your consolation brought me joy. Psalm 94, verse 19. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Philippians 4, verse 7. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Galatians 5 verses 22-23. You keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Isaiah 26 verse 3. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them, for the Lord your God goes with you, he will never leave you nor forsake you. Deuteronomy 31 verse 6. Thank you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that at the proper time he may exalt you, casting all your anxieties on him, because he cares for you. 1 Peter 5, verses 6 to 7. For I am the Lord your God who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you. Isaiah 41 verse 13. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble. Psalm 9, verse 9. Anxiety in a man's heart weighs him down, but a good word makes him glad. Proverbs 12, verse 25. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. John 14, verse 1. Thank you. Lord is near to the brokenhearted and saves the crushed in spirit. Psalm 34, verse 18. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. Proverbs 3, verse 5. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. Matthew 6, verse 33. But the Lord is faithful. He will establish you and guard you against the evil one. 2 Thessalonians 3, verse 3. In peace I will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety. Psalm 4, verse 8. Thank you. For God is not a God of confusion, but of peace. 1 Corinthians 14 verse 33. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Psalm 23 verse 4. Say to those who have an anxious heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save you. Isaiah 35 verse 4. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them, he delivers them from all their troubles. Psalm 34 verse 17. The Lord is my strength and my shield, in him my heart trusts, and I am helped, my heart exalts, and with my song I give thanks to him. Psalm 28 verse 7. Thank you. I sought the Lord, and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. Psalm 34, verse 4. Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, "What shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear?" Matthew 6, verse 31. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. Psalm 91, verse 1. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Colossians 3, verse 15. When I am afraid, I will put my trust in you. Psalm 56, verse 3. Thank you. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Matthew 11 verses 28 to 29. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Joshua 1 verse 9. For God gave us a spirit not of fear, but of power and love and self-control. 2 Timothy 1 verse 7. The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? Psalm 27 verse 1. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I have overcome the world. John 16, verse 33. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope. Jeremiah 29, verse 11.